So if you're looking for the best 49ers coverage here on YouTube, you came to the right place, and you have the opportunity to join a massive family. The 49ers Report by Chat Sports has 34,890 subscribers. Come on, we can get to 35,000 subscribers by the end of the day, so hit that big red button down below or go to youtube.com/49ersTV and subscribe to the Bang Bang Niner Gang. If you're at home and you're like, why should I subscribe to this channel? We bring you the latest news and rumors. We hit you with the analysis, but we also like to have a lot of fun. And on Wednesday, the NFL is going to release its schedules. We're going to push out a video to see who the 49ers play and when. All incentives to subscribe to the 49ers Report. All right, welcome into the 49ers Report by Chat Sports. I am Chase Senior. Today, we're going to take a look at five trade targets for the 49ers, and we're going to look at players both on the offensive and defensive side of the football. We kick it off with Julio Jones, who's been in trade rumors and trade discussions for a couple of weeks now, even leading up to the 2021 NFL Draft. If the 49ers were to make a trade for Julio Jones, it would be a clear win-now move because, let's be honest, he's on the back nine of his career, and he's in his early 30s, so his days as a premier wide receiver, probably over. Here's the thing, though. Financial considerations. He is a very expensive player for the player that he currently is at this point in his career. He's due $26.8 million over the next 2 years. For the 49ers, there would be a potential out after 2022 with $7.75 million in dead money. So it would affect the salary cap a little bit. In 2020, Julio Jones was a really good player. Here's the big concern, though. Those injuries are starting to pile up, and his season was basically cut in half because of ongoing injury problems. Still, really productive. 51 receptions, 771 yards, average yards per catch, still elite at over 15, and brought in 3 touchdowns. Julio Jones, there is no doubt he is going to be a future Hall of Famer, and in his prime, one of the best wide receivers in the history of the NFL. And while the injuries have caught up to him to a certain degree, he is still producing. My concerns, he's older, as I mentioned, he's also injury prone. To add on to that, also pretty expensive. And the big question for San Francisco would be this: what do you give up for a player like Julio Jones, and what would the Atlanta Falcons be asking for? But if you put him on this offense with Deebo Samuel, Brandon Ayuk, George Kittle, and Julio Jones, I don't care if it's Jimmy Garoppolo starting week one, or if it's Trey Lance, or if these weapons are together for when Trey Lance is the quarterback of this team, that right there is a scary, scary offense with a lot of potential in the current day and also in the future if Julio Jones can extend his career a little bit. So the faithful, what do you think? Should the 49ers trade for Julio Jones? Get your votes in the comment section below. Type T for trade or type P for pass. Let's pivot to Zach Ertz, tight end for the Philadelphia Eagles. And the Birds have been trying to trade Ertz ever since the 2020 season ended. And the Eagles did grant Zach Ertz the opportunity to seek a trade. They just haven't been able to find a trade partner for him because there is no leverage for the Eagles because he's coming off a really down year in 2020. And look, I know Zach Ertz is coming off a year that wasn't all that great. I would love to see Kyle Shanahan run more 12 personnel. I think it would add another element to this offense, and I think Zach Ertz still has some gas left in the tank. From 2014 to 2019, he was one of the best tight ends across the entire NFL, and he's going to go down as probably the best tight end in the history of the Eagles. But from 2014 to 2019, he was putting up numbers, almost 500 receptions during that span, almost 5,300 yards, average yards per catch at almost 11, so he was a bona fide chain mover, and he was a touchdown machine, 31 touchdowns. In 2020, it was a disastrous year for him and the Eagles. Now, a couple reasons for that. He was hampered by injuries, but also Carson Wentz had one of the worst seasons of any quarterback in the history of the NFL. That's why the numbers are what they are for Zach Ertz in 2020. 36 receptions, 335 yards, not good at all, and only a single touchdown. I think this would be a buy low, potential high reward for the 49ers, and I don't think they'd have to give up all that much because the Eagles don't have leverage because they haven't been able to trade him. Teams out there know that. So should the 49ers trade for Zach Ertz? Get into the comments, let me know. Type Y for yes or type N for no. Let's get to another offensive weapon. I'm really intrigued by this. Michael Gallup, wide receiver of the Dallas Cowboys. He's going to be an unrestricted free agent after this season. That's why I put him on this list of five guys who the 49ers could trade for. And so far, Dallas has not given him an extension, and there really hasn't been much contract talks about the Dallas Cowboys bringing him back. Why is that? They're pretty invested at wide receiver. CeeDee Lamb, as well as Amari Cooper. But since getting drafted in the third round out of Colorado State a couple of years ago, he's been a really productive player. And I think Kyle Shanahan would allow Michael Gallup to be even more productive. Here are his career stats over the last 3 years. 158 receptions, almost 2,500 yards, 13 touchdowns, average yards per catch of around 15.5. This is a guy who can kind of line up anywhere, can take the top off of the defense as well, can kind of run crossing routes as well. I like his route tree and the versatility that he would bring to this 49ers receiving core. Do you think Michael Gallup would be a good trade target to join forces with Brandon Ayuk and Deebo Samuel at the wide receiver spot? Type 1 for yes or type 2 for no. Get your votes in the comments section. Today's show is made possible by our friends at Newsbreak. Now, nowadays, we have a bunch of apps on our phones, and it can be overwhelming. But we all know some of the best apps on our phones that are the go-tos. And for me, that is the Newsbreak app. So do me a favor, support us here at Chat Sports and support the 49ers report by going to chatsports.com/49NB and download the Newsbreak app right now. You have to use that link for us to get credit and to support us here at Chat Sports. Here are some of the great advantages of the app. On one single feed from all of your local news sources, after you plug in your zip code, you get your local news and weather, your politics, pop culture, and food, as well as your sports content. And oh yeah, 49ers report content is also on the Newsbreak app as well. You just go to chatsports.com/49NB, search the 49ers report, and give us a follow. And I also want to challenge the faithful right now, because last week on 49ers Report Live, I said, we have to catch up to the Las Vegas Raiders in terms of Newsbreak followers. You helped me out. We're almost there. Raiders still beating us 475 to 432, but look at the ground that we've made up, and look how we're on top of the Seattle Seahawks, a fellow NFC West rival. They only have 294 followers. You guys are all killing it. So once again, chatsports.com/49NB. Download the Newsbreak app today. I'm going to put that link in the description as well as the comments. Let's shift over to the defensive side of the football. DeMeco Ryans, first-year defensive coordinator for the 49ers, would love to get his hands on Eric Kendricks. Probably reminds him a little bit of who DeMeco Ryans was as a player when he was playing for the Houston Texans and Philadelphia Eagles. Eric Kendricks, local-ish guy, went to Cal, modeled his game after the great Patrick Willis, who's one of the best 49ers defenders of all time. And while he might be available on the trade market, Vikings only have around $4 million in cap space. And while Kendricks is a very good player, he's also a pretty expensive player. In 2018, signed a five-year, $50 million contract. But he has been so productive for Mike Zimmer's defense throughout his entire career, and for 6 years has been one of the best linebackers across the NFL. 100-plus tackles in 5 of 6 seasons, 38 tackles for loss over the last 6 years, 41 career pass breakups. So he's pretty good when he has to drop back in coverage and is also active when he drops back in coverage. And as I mentioned, I mean, Eric Kendricks, brother of Michael Kendricks, who is also a pretty solid NFL linebacker, is one of the best linebackers across the entire NFL. So you have Fred Warner. Do the 49ers need Eric Kendricks? Let me know. Interested to see what you guys say. Type N for yes, they need him, or type D for nah, we're good. We don't need him on this defense. Let's round out these trade targets with Davante Adams. This is pretty juicy because the drama between Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers continues. And Davante Adams said he'd do, quote, extra thinking about his future if Aaron Rodgers were to decide to retire or if he was traded elsewhere. Davante Adams might be available too, because if the Packers trade away Aaron Rodgers. Maybe they want to get maximum value for both him and Davante Adams, because Adams is going to be an unrestricted free agent after the 2021 season. Local guy, too. How about he comes back home and rocks the scarlet and white unis? I'm all for it. Went to Palo Alto High School as well as Fresno State, where he played with Derek Carr. And last year, he put up historic numbers. Now, keep in mind, this is over 14 games, yet he still caught 115 balls for nearly 1,400 yards and 18 touchdowns. Record-breaking season for Davante Adams. And yes, he's currently 28 years old. I think he's going to be 29 this upcoming season. You risk maybe paying him a large contract after this season, but my gosh, since he's been in the league, he's been one of the top wide receivers on the outside across the league. And I think he'd be able to put up numbers in this 49ers offense. So I want to pose this question for you all watching right now. The faithful, I appreciate you. What would you give up for Davante Adams? It could be draft picks. It could be players. Let me know in the comment section below. So the five players that the 49ers could trade for, presented to you by Chat Sports and the 49ers Report: Julio Jones, wide receiver with the Atlanta Falcons; Zach Ertz, tight end with the Philadelphia Eagles. He'd be an awesome backup to George Kittle. He's only 30 years old. Michael Gallup, wide receiver with the Dallas Cowboys, going to be a free agent after this upcoming season. Same with Davante Adams, wide receiver of the Green Bay Packers; and Eric Kendricks, linebacker with the Minnesota Vikings.